to have this security, you know that you're settled. To secure is to be settled. No matter what will happen to me, I'm sick today, I have no money today, I have no money in the bank, my work will be secure. Even though maybe there will be some turbulence in the coming days, but you know that God is in control. You will find something that God will work with you. So there will be rejoicing, and it will be an inward peace. The third one, so here, the fruit of the Spirit is just, I mentioned this because it's important, Galatians 23, love, joy, peace, because some of them are being mentioned here. That's why it is, it's important that we have to know them. So the next one is, godly, you can find rejoicing, or you can rejoice in the Lord through godly contentment. You know the story of Paul, that before he became a Christian, remember that he was contented in life. I think he's a well-off person. Remember, he's a Pharisee. He's a member of the tribe of Benjamin. He was a learned person. People respected him. What more? But when he became a Christian, God placed him in a different situation. God said, I will use you for a special purpose. Well, what happened to him is that there were times that he was shipwrecked, he was mobbed, he was, you know what happened to Paul? So there was a time that he was in need, financial need. And the people, the Philippians, because they have the joy in the Lord, because they are at peace with God, they saw the need. You know, if you see a need of other people, collectively, just talk. May kapatid tayo, because the brother or sister is in need. Can we share something? I'm sharing this because I don't know if you know the God's dwelling place. God's dwelling place is a church, mostly Filipino, in Rambla. And there was a couple who went to the Philippines for a mission and vacation. In the north, they had an accident, a huge accident. Okay? Just recently. Okay? So, they have travel insurance. However, that they have to be transported from the province to Manila, and the plane, the helicopter plane, is not included in the travel insurance. So they have to pay for the insurance. So the church heard about this. They started, don't you feel it? I can feel it. As we speak today, they have a fundraising now in God's very place. Just to meet the needs of our brothers. Paul was in need. The only mission is the big. Paul was not a beggar. He's content with what he has, whether he was in his stomach or empty. He's content. And you can find rejoicing in the Lord, you have nothing. He was on the extreme side of being rich. He was on the extreme side of being poor financially. But let us go back a little bit in chapter 3. I want you to read this. Chapter 3, verse 7. Because this is what Paul said. Philippians 3, 7. I once thought all these things were so very important, but now I consider them worthless because of all prizes and achievements, everything, riches in life. They thought this is important in life. And when he realized what God has done for him, these are not important. The important thing is relationship. Again, we go back to the topic, relationship. Because everything that we're talking about here is about relationship. Remember, outward harmony is about relationship. in one piece? How can you have good relationship with other people? You yourself, inwardly, you are at war with yourself. And contentment, whether food or anything, you cannot find joy in the Lord. But always, I'm saying this because when I mentioned about gratitude, this is the word here is gratitude expressed. He was very thankful. Paul was very thankful for the being in the church. He was not begging. He was not asking. But the Philippian church had a different eye. This person needs something. We collect something for him. And this, it says here, this is the only church who saw it. And they did it not only once, but many times over. So he was just being very expressive. And if you receive blessing, express it. Praise God. Thank God. Brother, thank you for helping me. Sister, I really appreciate it. Sometimes if you have to cry, just tears of joy, do it. You have to express. No, not, don't fake it. Express what's your inside. Thank you, Lord. I don't see this coming. It's here. And the lesson learned is that not 111, but 110 and 11. And the thing here is that lesson learned here is that a lot of people learn from each other. Paul learned from the Philippians. Philippians learned from Paul. It's both things. And both of them learned from God. Still, it's the overarching. It's still God working in the hearts and minds of people. And here, it's almost related to each other because it's in verses 10 to 20. This is about giving and receiving. Okay. If you're a person who always gives, okay, then there might come a time that you are in need. Don't be proudful of receiving now. Because I've seen people, they used to giving, helping people. Now they were in need. Oh no, I can do it. Remember Peter? Washing the feet of the disciples. What did Peter say? No, don't wash my feet. If you're going to wash my feet, wash my body. It's kind of something like that. Because you're used to giving people, helping people. Now you're the receiving end. And baliktad eh. You're the ones in need. If somebody's helping you, accept it graciously. Graciously. So still, because part of our Christian life is that sometimes you have to give. And sometimes you have to receive. Because other people may be, you may be in good now, learn how to give. Maybe there will come a time that you are in need. If somebody can help you, thank you. I will take it. So this is to rejoice in God's contentment. Before he used to give, now he's starting to receive. Just imagine a very wise person. Humanly speaking, Paul was a very wise person. He was a very proud person. His background was good, but he said it. I consider him not important anymore. So now, he is on the receiving end now. And this is why Paul wrote this, "My God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory." But let us read first the verse before that. Philippians 4:19. Okay, this is in the New Living Translation. "And this same God who takes care of me will supply all your needs from his glorious riches, which have been given to us in Christ Jesus." So you can see the recognize, we acknowledge that all good things are from above. All good things are from above. And I don't know, because in life, you don't know what will happen. Maybe you are good in the past, but you will come again. Or maybe you are nothing. You have not, almost nothing in the past, but now God has blessed you. So you recognize, you look back a little bit. Who was I depending before? But now, God has blessed you. God has richly blessed you. And to rejoice in the Lord, it's about having a wonderful, you know, harmony inside. Because you belong in this fellowship, body fellowship. So make sure that, I think I would like to have a wonderful fellowship with you. You know what? Honestly, for myself, I think I'm a peacemaker, by the way. I'm not those things, okay? I'm just telling you something important. I think I want to be a peacemaker. However, if somebody's trying to be mad at me, I don't feel comfortable. Because I'm used to helping people to get better together. But if somebody's abusing me, oh, what did I do? I feel uncomfortable if somebody's accusing me of something. Because I don't want to be like that. I want to help other people join together. So, I think that's part of the relationship topic that we have. Relationship with you. Make sure that you be considerate, be gentle to one another, be prayerful. Everything that we have touched a while ago. Trustful. And because of the peace that you have in Christ, you will feel secure. Secure. Whether you want or not you want. So, shall we praise God?
Amen. Amen.
Praise God. I want to hear praise God.
Praise God.
Amen. Amen. Let us go to God in prayer. Father, we continue to humble ourselves before you, God. We have nothing to boast. You are a rich God. And out of your goodness, out of your righteousness, out of your gentleness and kindness to us, we are recipients of your goodness, God. Father, we just want to express ourselves to you. We thank you, O God, for everything that you have done, especially through Christ Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the Spirit of God who is moving in our midst, O God, helping us to understand your word. It's not my words, not our words, but your word, O God. Help us to stand firm, O God, and look at other people with consideration, Father. Help us to have allowances, gentleness, being joyful, and being prayerful and trustful, so that we can have the peace that passes all understanding, O God. And we know that we are secure because we are in Christ Jesus. So, Father, we just want to bring back all the glory and honor and credit. In the name of Christ, we pray all these things. Amen.